Sometimes, taking a minute to have a closer look at things that seemingly look fine may just result in saving your life. Today's video contains the stories of women who thought they looked fine, when actually, something was lurking beneath the surface of their skin. Bethany Greenway was pregnant when she noticed a spot on her forehead that looked like a giant freckle, but she quickly dismissed it as a mere symptom of pregnancy. Soon, this misconception would bring her face to face with something she had been running from all her life. As time passed, what Greenway and her husband Benjamin had thought to be a mere spot started growing into a mole and began to ache seriously. Amidst all these ailments, Greenway had one big fear, the fear of having melanoma. So deep down, she hoped that wasn't the case. You see, Greenway's mom had melanoma when she was in her 30s, so Greenway knew she was also at risk of having the disease. For instance, she had already inherited more than enough freckles from her mom, so she hoped the disease would be merciful enough to stay away from her. However, Greenway found her fears flying away when she visited the doctors for the first time. They told her that the growth was nothing to worry about. Sadly, this diagnosis would turn out to be wrong, and Greenway would have to prepare her mind for the worst. In due course, Greenway's condition started to deteriorate, and she had to do a biopsy immediately. The result was something Greenway never wanted to hear. She was having melanoma too. Although she had done almost everything possible to prevent this, she didn't tan her skin, nor did she ever have a sunbath. Yet, it came knocking. Come what may, Greenway knew she had to be strong for her other kids, who couldn't even understand what she was going through. As the time for a treatment drew near, Benjamin rearranged his duties and worked most of the time from home, so he could help out with the kids. Finally, it was time for surgery. During the operation, the doctors removed some tissues and muscles around Greenway's forehead. They also took out a skin graft from her thigh to cover the parts of her forehead that were taken out. After this, Greenway hoped her struggle with melanoma would be over, but a second test revealed something even more devastating. Some of the tissues obtained from the first surgery had been tested to see if there was a chance that the cancer had spread. Sadly, the results showed that it had, which meant Greenway had to go in for another surgery. This time around, the doctors removed one of Bethany's lymph nodes as the cancer tissues had spread to the area. Although both surgeries yielded some positive results, it was only the beginning of a terrifying journey Greenway had never envisaged. After the surgeries, Greenway had to start immunotherapy, a cancer treatment that boosts the body's natural defenses to fight cancer. Even though it proved effective in the end, Greenway had to pay greatly. One part of the treatments that left a dent in Greenway's life was the radiation stage, which caused extreme fatigue, permanent hair loss, and dry mouth. During these trying times, Greenway reminisced about the old days. Her once healthy and beautiful life flashed before her eyes. Perhaps things would have been a little different if she had acted fast, she thought. Despite the depth of her regret, there were still bigger hurdles ahead. One of them was the big gash the surgery left on her forehead, but rather than let it affect her self-esteem, she turned things around and even named the scar Bacon. It doesn't end there. She also named a yellow compression sponge SpongeBob's A-hole. The sponge was sewn onto her forehead to hasten her recovery, which as time passed wasn't so far anymore. Eventually, after several months that seemed like an unending forever to Greenway, the treatments left her with no traces of melanoma. Glad to have her life back, Greenway created a Facebook page, Melanoma Photo Diary, which she constantly uses to raise awareness about skincare. Hers is a story of resilience worth commending. A similar story is that of Erin Youngerberg. Growing up in Minnesota, Erin attended college in Milwaukee. Then she worked for some time in Ohio and North Carolina before ending up in New Jersey. As a photographer and traveler, Erin had always lived life to the fullest until something happened. It all started with a mole on her upper right back that was slightly raised and pink. Since it looked pretty harmless, Erin disregarded it. However, on second thought, she decided to ask her primary doctor about it and was relieved when the doctor told her she had nothing to worry about. But this was a far cry from the truth, and it didn't take long before Erin's symptoms worsened. While vacationing in 2010, Erin's mole started to grow larger and it began to bleed. Terrified, she ended her vacation and rushed back to the States. Then, she booked an appointment to get the mole removed. At this point, she could never have imagined what the problem was, and a later visit to the hospital would leave her completely dumbstruck. After a visit to the dermatologist, who later booked her with an oncologist, the truth came out when Erin had a biopsy done. The result was heartbreaking. She had stage 3 melanoma. Treatments started immediately, and all the lymph nodes under Erin's right arm were removed, but sadly, it didn't end there. Some months later, the disease returned to her small intestine, and it was during this period that Erin finally qualified for Merck's anti-PD-1 clinical trial. Although the clinical trials took most of Erin's day and exposed her to a boring routine she could never have imagined, her health improved greatly. Despite her frequent visits to the clinic, she still created some time to travel and has been dedicated to spreading the word about melanoma awareness. A true fighter she was. Perhaps beginnings are usually scary and endings are unpredictable, but certainly it's everything in between that makes life worth living, as in the case of Estela Melendez, a woman whose story will have you gripped from start to finish. In the Pacific coastal community of La Boca, Chile, Estela Melendez lived happily with her husband, Manuel Gonzalez. As newly wedded, each second mattered, and the couple channeled all their time and resources into building something beautiful and inseparable. This bond they had created carried them through their marriage. Although they never lived in a mansion, they still lived in a humble and content life. Manuel, a boatman and fisherman, did all he could to provide for him and his wife. While it seemed like his family was a happy one, something was missing. Kids. Despite several attempts and after trying their hands at all they could, the couple was still unable to conceive. As time passed, it became their greatest regret and deepest pain, so the couple gave up trying, a move that Estela would regret in the future. Despite the couple's inability to have kids, something shocking happened later on in their lives. Estela suddenly developed a lump in her belly. The couple didn't know how it got there and why, but they never thought of it as something serious. With time, the lump started aching a little, but that physical pain was nothing when compared to the big hole that the absence of a child had left in Estella's heart, so she paid no attention. Soon enough, that lump became a poignant reminder that she and her husband would never be able to fulfill their dreams of having a child. In 2015, Estela woke up to find her 74-year-old husband had quietly passed. After spending decades building a life with her soulmate, the loss was incalculable. They shared so much together, including their deepest regret, the inability to have kids. She could have taken this to the grave, but the shocking events that later transpired were too much for her to take. Estela had to break that secret bond by sharing her story with the world. After Manuel's death, things only got worse for the widow. Her mobility dwindled, and she also developed a rare case of arthritis. But one incident marked the beginning of a long-due revelation. While tending to her house one day, Estela tripped and fell. Although there was no physical damage, her doctor suggested a full-body x-ray, and this led to a startling discovery. After the x-ray was carried out, what the doctors discovered was almost otherworldly. It turned out Estela was technically pregnant, but with a dead fetus, and this was what had prevented her from getting pregnant all her life. The doctors revealed an even bigger shock. A close study showed that Estela had been pregnant with the fetus for roughly 60 years. This news crushed Estela beyond repair. It was crippling to think that all the while her unborn child was unknowingly inside of her for over 60 years. Although it sounded mysterious, Estelle's condition is a syndrome known as lithopedian, or a stone baby. It occurs when a pregnancy goes wrong, and the calcified layer that forms around the fetus protects the mother from its dead tissue. Oftentimes, people with a stone baby go into surgery to have the dead fetus removed, but in Estelle's case at 91, her doctors determined that she would be too old to survive the surgery, so she had to continue living that way. Estela didn't mind carrying the remains of her fetus with her to the grave. She also thought it a reminder of her late husband. Although it was painful to realize that all they ever wanted was under their noses all along, Estela dethroned a belief that made her feel awful all her life. Finally, she knew she was capable of conceiving. Soon enough, her story caught the attention of people and made the front page of several media outlets, and she found herself granting several interviews. Although her husband would never have done such, she knew the story had to be told. However, as the years passed by, she managed to steer clear of the media and went back to living a quiet and peaceful life. Indeed, time has always been the greatest ally to truth because it eventually relieves and reveals all. Have you ever found something seemingly harmless on your body, and then it turns out serious?